Welcome back to Let's Talk Business series by Realty NXT. This is Pradanjali Rawal. On this episode, we have Mr. Alok Bhunia, Chief Executive Officer, Ascendis First Space Platform. The Ascendis First Space Platform is a joint venture between Ascendis, a member of Capital Land Limited, and First Space Realty. Thank you so much for joining us today. How are you doing, Mr. Bhunia?
I'm good, and thank you for having me on your show.
Okay, so let's start with, how do you think growth in logistics and warehousing sectors will boost the Indian economy?
So if you look at it, there are few sectors in any economy which are fundamental to that economy. And logistics is one such sector, and construction is considered to be another such sector. So whatever we consume, whatever we manufacture, whatever we export needs to be transported, needs to be reached to the place from where we consume, whether it's a shop, whether it's to a e-commerce platform who delivers to your house. And all of those things together constitutes the logistics sector. And it has various components, including the transportation, the storage, and the distribution. And for growth of any economy, the efficiency of logistics sector plays a very significant role. And that is why you would find that in one of our logistics missions by the government of India, it has been targeted that over the period of next few years, we target to reduce our logistics cost as percentage of GDP, which today is anywhere between 12 to 13% to something like a single digit between 9 to 10%. And as we do, as we are able to achieve efficiency, as we are able to achieve modernization and adapt technology, these are only going to improve the logistics sector, and in the same way, it is going to improve the GDP as a whole.
Okay. So due to strong consumer spending, the growth of e-commerce and other factors, warehousing and logistic companies are incorporating more automation and tech into their operations to streamline administrative tasks and give more visibility to customers. How at Ascendis First Space, you are adopting technology like IoT, AI, to create modernization and optimization of warehousing operations?
Little background. We are provider of logistics infrastructure. So we develop logistics and industrial park, and where any of the operators, whether it's a e-commerce operator or an FMCG or a 3PL operator, takes up those space and set up their operations. So we don't do operations per se as ourselves. However, the products that we develop, the warehouses that we build, the infrastructure that we create, the facilities that we provide inside the warehouses, we keep in mind that modernization and technology adoption by our tenants are going to be possible within these warehouses. Those are specifications and infrastructure we develop helps our customer to adapt those technologies. Having said that, probably in the near future, as things progresses, there might be, we as developers might start investing a lot more, not only in terms of the enabling infrastructure, but also in some cases, the equipments or such technologies ourselves.
Okay, that sounds great. So with a focus on Make in India, the local businesses who are into manufacturing business will need storage and logistics services. Do you think that shared logistics can help put MSMEs on a recovery path with infrastructure, operational support from the large firms?
It is already happening. If you break down the some of the changes that has happened in the whole logistics and distribution over the last few years, you will find that thing is already happening. I mean, what does an e-commerce do? I mean, today you can buy from a small supplier in somewhere in Ludhiana and that gets delivered into your house in Bombay. The whole value chain, including the logistics and everything, is handled by Amazon, which it would not have been possible before e-commerce. So all these things are happening because there is a shared platform for all the sellers, which is nothing but an e-commerce. That's on one side. On the other side, the 3PL operations, which earlier was based on single customer, single contract, is changing where there are more and more shared services which are being promoted. So 3PL operators are providing solutions which are not only suited for large customers, but where aggregation of smaller or MSME customers are possible, and therefore they are able to avail of these services which was not possible for them earlier.
Okay, absolutely. So my next question for you is, we have seen a shift towards A-grade warehouses. Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities emerge as preferred destination for warehousing industry. What are your thoughts on the same?
So if you look at India, the real estate per se started upgrading sometimes around late 90s, early 2000s. So you started seeing movement towards grade A offices. You started seeing we moving from shopping centers to malls, residential apartments, which are like larger apartments with all modern amenities, which started early 2000. But the warehousing and the industrial real estate sector really did not modernize at that point of time. It practically started sometimes around 2007-8. And like efficiency, which was required in every other sector, and because of which the technology adoption and other things, the modernization happened in other real estate, the same thing started happening in 2008 onwards for warehousing sector per se. With GST, with e-commerce, and with increasing adoption of technology, what took probably the other sector longer periods, this thing happened faster for warehousing sectors in last 2 to 3 years. And we see that this is going to grow faster over the period of next 5 to 10 years. And sorry, you had another question on the tier two. I think same trend is going to happen in the tier two. Again, I mean, I'll draw an analogy with the other real estate sectors. I mean, the movement towards malls or grade A offices or large modern residential complexes first started in the cities of Delhi, Bombay, or Bangalore. Then you move towards tier two cities of Coimbatore or like a Kochi or other cities. I think the same thing is happening in warehousing as well, because what we call tier two cities in India, actually, if you look at any of the city like Lucknow or Jaipur, it is like any big city in terms of population compared to any other European countries. So in terms of the number of people, in terms of the consumption, it is a significant market. And therefore, we strongly believe that tier two is going to be a driving force for the growth of the sector.
Okay. So, recently, Capital Land launched a second warehousing fund in India worth 2,250 crores to expand India's logistics sector. How are you planning to utilize these funds, and which are the sectors you're operating into? Later, after this part, please answer that which is your favorite current market where you believe that huge growth is going to happen.
So we focus on industrial real estate. So which primarily there are two parts we do. One is the logistics park, which are purely development of warehouses for storage and distribution of materials. We also do industrial parks, which are for manufacturing clients, where clients come and set up their manufacturing facilities, which are assembly or value-added operations and stuff like that. And we believe that both sectors are going to be quite important for two reasons. One, The Make in India initiative by Government of India, which along with the various incentive schemes for manufacturing in India, the Government of India has started, which is seeing a significant amount of traction. And because of that, we believe that significant amount of manufacturers will start setting up their base, and which is already started. That's going to be one of our primary focus areas, which is in industrial parks. Warehousing, which is the logistics parks, will continue to be one of our primary focus areas. And we will focus on the large tier one as well as the tier two cities. If you look at our fund one, we were primarily focused on five cities, tier one cities. But in our fund two, we will also focus on few of the tier two cities which we believe in. We don't have any favorites because we believe that the potential across all the large tier one and tier two cities exist. And we will be opportunistic basis wherever we get the first opportunity to invest among these target cities, we will do that.
Okay, so right now you have mentioned, you've spoken about Make in India campaign. So we know that government has introduced recently many policies which have provided a huge boost to the warehousing sector. What more is needed by the government that will help this industry grow? So what's your take on the same?
I mean, this is something which I talk actually on most of these government forums which I attend, especially on the logistics policy side. I think there is, I won't say misplaced, but there is a thought inside the government circles, which they do in most of the cases. For growth of a sector, the focus mostly from the policymakers reside on the side of providing a subsidy. I think the logistics sector don't need subsidy. It is a sector which has requirement, which has growth, which has demand and everything. So I don't think it is the subsidy which will boost the growth of the sector. What is required is few structural reforms which are more important. One of the biggest structural reform, which I think it's not only for logistics sectors, but across all the industries they are asking for, is the land. Because you need huge tracts of land for developing this large infrastructure for logistics, whatever we are building. And unless the land acquisition is made easier, the availability of document, the disposal of litigation, if any, unless that process is made easier and faster, it always becomes more and more difficult and challenging to invest and grow. And the second part I would say is in terms of approvals and permissions. Again, this is the same thing which I hear across the board, including the people I talk with from abroad who are looking to set up manufacturing facilities in India, is it has to be a single point, single window clearance for all the projects that you are trying to set up. I mean, in cases you have to go like 20, 30 agencies to get your approvals where norms are not really known. Sometimes they are not transparent. It is that uncertainty which stops a lot of people from investing and growing. I think if those two are answered, those two are handled properly, I think there will be a multitude of investment in this sector.
Okay. So now let's talk about the future of rental warehousing. According to a recent report published by Cushman and Wakefield, Indian cities are among the least expensive market in terms of rental for warehousing and logistic facilities. So how do you see the future of rental warehousing and logistics in the upcoming years?
I think there are two questions to that. One, are we going to see more rental model in this sector growing, or we are going to see more ownership driven model? I have absolutely no doubt in my mind that rental model will grow. People, and I get this question because some of the e-commerce players have done one or two investments where they are trying to own the warehouses. But that will be more strategic, one of kind of an investment. It is going to be largely driven by a rental model, because the risk return for each of the businesses being different and the expertise required for development of each of the business on the real estate side as well as on the business they run is different. So there is absolutely no doubt in my mind that rental model will prevail in the long run. And that is going to be probably more than 90-95% of whatever the consumption happens in the sector. In terms of the rental pricing, yes, you're absolutely right. India is one of the lowest in terms of the pricing. I mean, even after factoring in the exchange or the purchasing power parity. And there, I believe that we will pass through a time and we will probably going to experience a similar kind of a trend what China experienced, which is there is going to be a rental bump. But that bump is going to be a sudden. It's not going to be a linear growth. I think at some point when the demand is going to be significant, when people realize and there are going to be much more significant penetration of grade A space, I think we will see sudden jump in terms of the rental. It is difficult to say whether it's going to happen in the next 6 months, 1 year, or it may take 3 years, 5 years. But I strongly believe that we are looking at a strong rental growth in the next 5 to 7 years.
Okay, that sounds great. So I have one last question for you. What are the new innovations that Indian market is yet to see? What challenges do you think Indian market has that young entrepreneurs who are entering this tech field can be solved?
So, on the logistics side, actually, there are two parts. One is the transportation. On the transportation side, there is still a significant amount of wastage which happens. Whether it is through bad network planning, whether it's through inability to monitor the movement of goods and stuff like that. There have been quite a lot of innovation in that. In terms of you see quite a lot of new tech companies which have entered into the space. But I still think there is a lot which is possible, especially with respect to the last mile delivery. I still think that there is a strong possibility of reducing that cost and come out with more innovation in that. On the warehousing, inside the warehousing, where the whole handling of goods and all happen, I think we are at par with globally, especially in some of the sectors like e-commerce and all. Yes, globally, you will find some of the more developed countries gone for full automation. Given the labor cost in India, we probably are still a little far away from adopting full automation. So that part is not a question of inability to technology adoption, it's a question of economics. But on the last mile delivery, I think there is a scope for significant innovation.
So thank you so much for such an insightful session. Thank you so much. To viewers of Realty NXT, we will be back with many more exciting brand stories. Till then, stay tuned and keep watching Realty NXT. Thank you so much.